Facebook. It is Sue Brooke coming to you live from Northern California, Sonoma County in Sebastopol. And here is my Facebook Live for January 3rd, 2019. And it is my next business tip. So here it is. I meant to do this actually a little earlier tonight at a place where I was speaking at the Santa Rosa Holistic Chamber. I was talking about why it is so important to be an author if you are an entrepreneur. Why is it absolutely essential and mandatory that you are an author, okay? So first of all, the first time I ever became an author was when I was in a huge mastermind program, and I had a mentor that kept saying, you guys all have to write a book, you have to write a book. And at the time, I owned an educational learning center. I had 20 employees. I had two locations, 250 miles apart. I was busy. I was way too busy to write a book. And so I said, well, what am I supposed to write about? I really don't have time for this at all. So he said, well, just write about what you know. So what did I do? Okay. Hey, Casey. Hey, oh my gosh, all my friends are on tonight. Lily and Susan and Michelle. Hey there. So anyway, going back to the book thing. So he said, well, just write what you know. And I said, okay, fine. So over the holiday break where all the kids were on break because I had a school, I said, fine, I will write about how to find the right tutoring program for your child. So that is what I did. And so on New Year's Eve, I just got a Facebook memory that told me that I became an author for the first time on New Year's Eve of 2014 going into 2015. It was called Tips on How to Find the Right Tutoring Program for Your Child. And oh my gosh, my friend from Turkey is on. Irfan, oh my goodness. So anyway, so books, let's go back to books. So my first book, I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I figured out how to format it, and I made a cover and I put it up on Amazon as an ebook. And guess what? The next morning, someone screenshotted something from Amazon that said I was a number one best-selling author. Number one. Oh my gosh. So I'm telling you something right now. It changed everything. Like, people came up to me that saw that and said, oh my gosh, you're famous, you're an author, right? And it really set my, it just made me into an expert and an authority. And people said, well, I want to get a copy of the book. And I said, well, I don't have a copy because it's just an ebook. So then I'm like, oh gosh, I gotta write a real book. So still, I did not have time to write a book. So what did I do? I was in this mastermind program. I stood up and I said, hey, who wants to come in with me in a book and do a compilation book? So what I did is I came up with Discover Your Identity. And it's going to be backwards because I've got the camera facing the wrong way. So Discover Your Identity was a compilation book, and 15 of us got together and we each put a chapter in the book. It's a compilation book, very similar to Chicken Soup for the Soul. I'm sure you guys all know that. So the first book was great. We did the book. It was awesome. And then the second book we did was Discover Your Inspiration. It was yellow. And here's what happened. I said, you know what? I think everybody should have a book with their picture on it. So everybody just has to write one chapter, but every person got a chance to have their own cover with their own ISBN and barcode and their own bio on the back, but they only had to write one chapter. Does that make sense? And guess what? By the next day, because we had 19 authors in the book, they told the whole world to buy the book. We became a number one bestseller the next morning at 7 a.m. So why is it so important to be an author in a book? Number one, I want to tell you, it is not about making money, okay? Absolutely not about making money. Yes, you can buy the books at wholesale prices and sell them and make a little money. Okay, great. That is not the intention when you're an entrepreneur to be an author, okay? The intention is to invest in yourself to do the book and make it a marketing material. It's marketing, right? So I'm just going to give you a few quick tips because I don't want to go on and on of why you should be an author in a compilation book, okay? And when I'm finished, I'm going to post a couple of links below because I'm actually producing several compilation books. One is in the holistic industry. The other one, I'm doing the next book, which is Discover Your Impact. So here we go. Why should be an author in a book? First of all, it gives you credibility. Credibility, expertise. You will be the expert in your industry. It doesn't even matter what you write about. It's the fact that you're an author that's going to set you apart from anybody else in the competition, right? You're going to gain the respect of your family and your friends and all those things. Boy, it really gets respect when people think that you're an author. Now, on a personal note, and I realize that I'm talking really fast, so I'm sorry. I don't want to keep going, so I don't want this to go on forever, but I have to tell you this. I moved to Northern California 1 year ago. Remember, I met my sister through Ancestry. I moved up here, and I didn't know one single person. But guess what happened? As I started meeting people, and as I started sharing that I was an author and I have a book, I had a book, people remember me. They remember me, and they know that I'm an author. So people will respect you. Another thing, and I've got my little trusty piece of paper here. Let's see. It enhances your credibility, and it makes you a thought leader in your industry. Now, we have Casey Eberhardt that's on here. He is a speaker. I guarantee you it's going to be a lot easier to get speaking engagements when you're an author and you have a book. I've gotten many speaking engagements purely because they said, oh, you're an author, you have a book, great, we want you to speak. They just automatically assume that you're an expert and an authority, right? The cool thing about being an author in a compilation book where there's a lot of authors is this. I am a huge proponent of being in every single compilation book you can possibly be in. Invest whatever you can to be in a compilation book. Why? Because it's a lot of authors are promoting it to all of their friends and their family and their clients and everything. So guess what? Instead of you just writing one book and then you're promoting it to the whole world, just you all by yourself, if you're in a compilation book, you have all these other people promoting yourself, you for that, promoting you, you know, because you are one of the authors in the book. Super, super important. Like I said, the second book I did in my Discover Your iBook series, we were a number one best-selling author in more than one category by the next morning because everybody promoted the book and shared it. Okay, what else? It's the best marketing tool you could ever have. It's better than a business card, right? When you're out networking and you have a book instead of a business card, I guarantee you, people are going to look at you differently. So another one that I publish, and like I said, these are going to be backwards because of the camera facing, but I publish these nice little books. Here's a regular size book. Here's the smaller book. Okay, I promote these too. These are awesome. If you want some information on how to do that, I think I see Marty Rogers is on here right now. I'm going to be hopefully producing or publishing her book, getting it done this weekend. I'm super excited. So, and you can go visit her, by the way, Financial Identity for Women. Yes, going to be an awesome book. So it can help you with your taxes because you can write it off. It's a marketing piece. It's a marketing tool you can write off on your taxes. Let's see. It's much less than it is to publish a real book. Okay. Yes, Marty, so excited. I'm going to be talking to you right after this. Let's see what else. You're going to be promoted to new audiences, right? When you are in a compilation book, then a lot of audiences are going to learn about you for sure. And the biggest thing is you're going to be inspiring people with your writing. It's going to be putting your knowledge and your, just everything, your story into print. That's going to live forever and ever. So you're building your legacy, right? It is so awesome. So anyway, those are just a few things. I don't want to keep going on and on, but I will do this. I will post below some ways that you can get involved in a few other compilation books. Please contact me, sue@suebrooke.com, or private message me here on Facebook since we're on here right now, and let me know if you want some help or you just want to talk about getting your book done. And I want to just double check one more time. It's not about making money. It's not about being a New York Times bestseller and making millions of dollars. Yes, maybe you can. Who knows? But that's not the intention when you're an entrepreneur. Okay? Earlier today, I posted for realtors to please post. I want to know who all my realtor friends are. Well, I know for a fact that realtors are a dime a dozen. There are thousands of them. There's so much competition in the real estate industry. What if you're the one realtor that wrote a book about something, okay? You are going to stand apart from everybody else in any industry. Hey, Lily, you're awesome. Okay, I'm going to get out of here. I love that you go on and on and on. Oh my gosh, well, I'm glad somebody does. Okay, I'm going to get out of here because I literally have to meet with Marty here, who is working on her little mini book. I'm so excited. So anyway, you guys have an awesome night. I promise I'll do my Facebook Live earlier tomorrow. I hope you have an incredibly awesome day. And post below if you have a book. Would love to see it. Post your Amazon link or whatever. And post if you're, you know, if you're thinking about writing a book. And if you are, what do you want it to be about? I would love to help you. It's a passion of mine. Okay, love you guys. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.